Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the economizer. So economizer basically is used in order to increase the temperature of the steam that is generated. So let us study the working of the economizer in detail. So an economizer is nothing but heat exchanger which raises the temperature of the feed water which is leaving at the highest pressure to the heater to about the saturation temperature corresponding to the boiler pressure. Now in order to do this, we need the hot flue gases which are exiting the last superheater or the reheater at the temperature which is varying from 370 degree centigrade to 540 degree centigrade. Now the term economizer was used historically because the throwing away of such high temperature gases involved a great deal of energy loss. So whenever the flue gases are let out, they consist of high amount of temperature. So it is nothing but the loss of energy when they are not utilized. So in case of economizer, the heat of the flue gases is utilized, hence the name economizer. So by utilizing these gases in heating the feed water, higher efficiency and the better economy were achieved, and hence the heat exchanger was called as economizer. Now the modern economizers are often designed to allow some boiling of the feed water in the outlet sections, that is up to 20% quality at the full power and the less part of loads. So they are often termed as steaming economizers. Now the economizer tube are commonly 45 to 70 mm in outside diameter, that is OD, and are made of the vertical coils of continuous tubes which are connected between the inlet and outlet headers, with each section formed into several horizontal paths which are connected by 1800 vertical bends. Now the coils are installed at a pitch of 45 to 50 mm spacings, which depends on the type of the fuel and the ash characteristics. Now figure A shows an economizer coil and the temperature profiles of flue gas and the water which is heated to the saturation temperature. So here the figure A shows the economizer coil and the temperature profiles of the flue gases and the water. So we can see here, this is the inlet header, then here we have outlet header, then again we have the graph which shows the profile. So here we have T saturation, then TG1, this is the graph for the gas and this is for the flue gutter. So the rate of heat transfer from the flue gases to the feed water is given by so Q economizer is equal to omega G multiplied by CpG multiplied by TG1 minus TG2. This equation can be further modified as Q economizer is equal to omega FW, that is for the feed water, multiplied by CpFW, again for the feed water, multiplied by bracket T saturation minus T feed water, which is further modified as Q economizer is equal to U0 A0 multiplied by delta T LM. Now let us see what are the various parameters in this equation. So delta T LM is equal to log mean temperature difference. So the formula for the delta T LM can be written as therefore delta T LM is equal to delta T I minus delta T divided by natural log delta T I divided by delta T. Further we can write as Q In the above equation, delta Ti is equal to Tg1 minus T saturation, delta T is equal to Tg2 minus T feed water, and 1 divided by U0 A0 is equal to 1 divided by HAC AI plus 1 divided by HI A1 plus XW divided by KW AIM plus 1 divided by HFO A0 plus 1 divided by HO A0. Now let us see what are these various terms. Now in the above equation, U0 represents overall heat transfer coefficient, HSE represents heat transfer coefficient due to the scale formed on the inside of tubes. Similarly, HI represents inside heat transfer coefficient, that is on the water side. Similarly, KW is equal to thermal conductivity of the wall material. Similarly, AI is equal to N pi DIL. A0 is equal to N pi D0L, where L represents length of the one coil, N represents total number of coils. Then AIM is equal to the log mean area, which is given by AIM is equal to A0 minus AI divided by natural log A0 divided by AI. Similarly, XW is equal to thickness of tube wall, then HFO is equal to heat transfer coefficient due to the solid on the outside surface of the tube. Similarly, H0 is equal to heat transfer coefficient. Now we can write, now if the resistance due to the scale, that is 1 divided by HSEAI, and fouling, that is 1 divided by HFOAO, are neglected, and if wall thickness is small, then the overall heat transfer coefficient is given by 1 divided by U0 is equal to 1 divided by HI plus XW divided by KW plus 1 divided by HO. So the gas side heat transfer coefficient is much less than water side heat transfer coefficient, that is H0 is very, very less than HI. So to compensate this, the outer surface of the tubes may be fined to increase the surface area of the heat transfer. Now both gas and liquid flow under the forced convection, for which we can write, Nu is equal to function of Re, Pr. Now let us see what are these parameters. In this equation, Nu represents Nusselt number, which is given by Hd divided by Kf. Similarly, RE represents Reynolds number, which is given by V bar D by VF. VF represents kinematic viscosity of fluid. PR represents Prandtl number, which is given by Cp mu F divided by Kf. Muf represents dynamic viscosity of fluid. Kf represents thermal conductivity of fluid film. So if it is considered that the flows are turbulent, then the Dts-Boltier equation can be used in order to evaluate the heat transfer coefficient, which is given by Nu is equal to 0.023 multiplied by Reynolds number, that is Re, raised to 0.8 multiplied by Pr raised to n. Now let us see what are the various terms in this equation. So in the above equation, n is equal to 0.4 if the fluid is heated and n is equal to 0.3 if the fluid is cooled. Now with the help of above two equations, we can estimate the value of U0. Now from equation 1, the surface area, that is A0, can be ascertained where A0 is equal to n pi d0 multiplied by L. Since the feed water is flowing through the tubes, at the exit from the economizer, with the water being saturated, we can write WFW, that is feed water, is equal to n multiplied by pi by 4 multiplied by di square multiplied by VFW divided by VF. Now let us see what are the various terms. So in the equation, VFW is equal to velocity of fluid at the exit, whereas small VF is equal to specific volume of the saturated water. Now it can be seen that higher the fluid velocity, less will be the film thickness and more will be the heat transfer coefficient. But higher velocity means more pumping power is required to be imparted to the fluid, that is V bar delta P, where V dot is equal to volume flow of the fluid, which is equal to omega FW. Similarly, small VF is equal to AI multiplied by FW. So the power required is thus proportional to the cube of the fluid velocity. This is because delta P is directly proportional to V square FW. Now these two conflicting considerations of the higher heat transfer and the more pumping power led into optimization of the fluid velocity. On the gas side, the velocity of the flue gases is about 10 to 12 meter per second. And on the water side, the velocity is limited to 1 to 1.2 meter per second. Now, if the water velocity is prescribed from equation 5, then the number of parallel coil paths required to accommodate the given flow can be estimated. Since A0 is already been computed, the length of one coil L can be determined. Now, if the clearance C is given on the two sides of the gas duct with the width B, then the number of turns of one coil can be estimated from NT is equal to 1 divided by B minus 2C. Again, if we consider the vertical pitch or the center to center distance of the consecutive horizontal tubes which are forming the coil, then P is assumed, then the height of the duct occupied by the economizer is equal to H eco is equal to NT multiplied by P. So the economizer is generally placed between convective superheater and the air preheater. So in this way, we have studied the working of the economizer. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.